Hey, what's up everyone? I'm your host RJ Neil and you're listening to Dil Dosti Ki Dasta podcast, the show where we relive and cherish the everlasting moments of our college life, only on Campus Spotlight, the exclusive radio station of IIT Palakkad. Work hard for your 12th boards and then you can enjoy the next 4 years.
I'm sure we've all heard that cliche line before. Oh, college, the phase where we learn to be independent, where friends become family, where staying up all night to do nothing is normal, and exams teach us teamwork.
My first day at IIT Palakkad, I think it was a mixture of nervousness and excitement. I was excited to see so many new faces and my room, which was gonna be my home for the next year. Hell, I was even excited to taste the mess food that everyone warned me about. And I still remember my first night, which was left sleepless because of so many mosquitoes. Well, me talking about my first day would be quite boring. So, on our first episode, we are joined by some of our friends who will be sharing their first day experience at IIT Palakkad.
Okay, so the first day experience at IIT Palakkad as a fresher was amazing, you know. First of all, I was really happy about getting an admit into an IIT. As soon as I arrived, it was, I think, the end of the July or start of the August, you know. The rainy season was at its peak and everywhere it was lush green, beautiful, you know. As I entered the campus, I saw a lot of greenery, birds flying around. I could see a few peacocks as well. So as soon as we reached near the academic block, the fields surrounding it were all green, the mountains and all. And it was really beautiful, you know. And not only me, but even my parents were also mesmerized looking at its beauty. So it was really amazing of an experience, you know. Regarding the hostel rooms, I was really happy to see the hostel facility, you know, because I have a lot of friends who are in old IITs and even I've personally been to a few other IITs. The hostel facility over there is not really good. So the kind of hostels we had were new, fresh and spacious with a benefit of attached toilet and bathroom. So I was really happy with the hostel facilities, you know.
So my first day at IIT Palakkad is one of my most cherished memories. When I reached the campus, it wasn't exactly what I imagined, but it was wonderful. Ayala campus is one of the most beautiful campuses I've ever seen. So the first day when I met all these new people with whom I was gonna spend the next 4 years of my life, I was super excited for the journey.
To be honest, I didn't like Ahilya's campus very much, okay? Because the population density is very less, first of all. And when I first went there, I was very alone, okay? I felt very alone. Because, I don't know, just the birds chirping and as a person who came from a town, I felt too alone, okay? Until I gathered my friends. If you ask me, I like Transit campus much better than Ahilya. Yeah, that's right.
The facilities in the academic block and hostel were good. The labs, the rooms, they were way beyond my expectation. At the beginning, we had ball, volleyball and table tennis. There was nothing much to do in the campus other than that. Even if you go outside the campus, you have to travel a lot to reach town. It was a little depressing at first. I guess we got used to that. But the most annoying thing was that lecture seat. I never understood why someone would use that in a class. You cannot stretch your legs without toppling what's on that pad. Also, that backrest was vertical, man. Does not support the weight of your upper body. Who made that trash? Compare that with the other bench in which two persons could sit. Man, there was enough ample space for both of us to just sleep on it. That was really good.
When I first saw the college, the hostels and the academic building and then the hostel rooms, it was pleasant because all the buildings were new and then the hostels had an attached bathroom. So this was the most comfortable hostel life one could ask for.
The first feeling when I saw it was, to be honest, I did not have much expectations to begin with. Since I've never stayed in an hostel before, that was my ground zero. Like, yeah, okay, so this is how a hostel is supposed to be. But I did expect a bit worse because unlike other IITs, ours was completely new, brand new. And the mess, the first day when we went, it was my father's reaction that the food is unexpectedly good. Like, he said that messes are usually much worse. I'm lucky to have a good mess. Only if he knew the quality was going to deteriorate just after a month. But yeah, it was better. I have seen worse and it was good enough for me.
Being away from my parents was not something new for me, because while I was preparing for JEE mains and advance, I was in Hyderabad, which was away from my parents because I'm from Maharashtra, and I was living at hostel, so I was kind of familiar to the hostel life. But Hyderabad was relatively near to my hometown as compared to Kerala, so yeah, my parents had their fears, you know, they always do, because they have always concern for their children. But I don't think it was a big deal for me to get adjusted to the surroundings, meeting new people and staying away from my parents. But yeah, in the initial days they used to call me every day, and eventually that reduced to one call alternate day, and eventually a few 2 to 3 calls a week. Yeah, so it was not a problem for me, I adjusted well.
Oh, the first week was very terrible, man. I really did miss my house. Maybe because I'm not a person who actually go and stays at my cousin's house and all. So maybe that, I don't know. I really did miss my home and Amma so much.
For me, it was the first time staying away from home for that long. I thought I would feel homesick after some time, but strangely that feeling never came. I guess having good friends had to do something with that. I had an awesome roommate my first year. All over, I had awesome roommates. I was lucky enough. The top floor of Hostel 1, that had a different vibe. Everyone missed home, but we were having a great time there. You know, we used to play Mini Militia. That's not like PUBG. We 10 guys sit in a room and play 5 versus 5 matches. That definitely helped going through those years.
To be honest, initially I was a bit afraid how would I manage. Like, I was woken up by my mother. Now I had to wake up with an alarm clock, and there was no Wi-Fi, no internet. I was not that used to the internet till then. We had recently gotten Wi-Fi then, but yeah, it was good. It did not make much of a difference, to be honest. I have kind of converted into an extrovert. The friends and all I made, the people I used to talk to, the time went by. It did not feel that far away from home. And yeah, video calls, simple calls, they were always there. The family was never far either. So not a big difference, I'd say.
Honestly speaking, I was not at all afraid of ragging and all. That was also reinforced by many of our faculty members in the orientation program, as I came to know that there's zero ragging policy, no tolerance to ragging in our college. I was not at all afraid of ragging, and on the very first day I met a few of the seniors, and they were really good. You know, they were answering each and every query or concern of ours with patience. You know, it was really good interacting with them. You know, it didn't feel like they were our seniors, it was just like they are our friends. There are a lot of seniors which I eventually developed a very good bond with, and I'm very blessed to have them in my life. Even in the initial few days, I was quite confident that there won't be any ragging or such sort of thing, and we had a pretty good interaction with all the seniors.
Oh, I did expect a ragging scene, but no one ragged me. Maybe because our seniors were too good not to rag, or they didn't know how to rag because they were the first batch of IIT Palakkad.
Maybe on the first day, we were afraid that we might be ragged, but that's it. Then we were never afraid of them ragging us, because the seniors were really friendly. I think none from our batch were ever ragged. It took some time to break the ice among us, but they always treated us with respect. The first batch of IIT Palakkad really set the culture against ragging, and we did our best to follow it. And there was never an incident among us that included ragging. There might have been altercations, yes, it never could be called ragging.
Well, there was no ragging at all, and I wasn't really afraid of ragging because there was only one batch of seniors. Plus, I think on the second day itself, we had started playing football together, volleyball together. That was a nice way to interact with them.
Ragging, like I've heard from my cousins and all. So I was just worried about the fact, ragging the sign. I was like, okay, I'll do it somehow. I just hope that they don't do it too embarrassing, or they don't push it to the limits. But thankfully, our seniors were very much mature, very much understanding. There was no ragging. The interaction with the seniors was really good. I can proudly say we weren't ragged as such. But yes, I was afraid, a bit concerned, just about the fact that I just hope that it did not went too far, and it was never like that, thanks to our seniors.
About the mess food, you know, I must tell you, the very first time when we had the mess food with our parents, it was really good. It was really good. It was delicious, you know. Even my parents were so happy that the mess food was really good, so they don't have to worry much about the food facility, because the mess was making good food, and the menu also seemed to be really good. which actually is really good. And yeah, the first day our experience at mess was really good, and for the first few days the experience was good, everything went well, they made some good food, it was hot, it was prepared on time. But yeah, eventually the quality goes down. But yeah, when it's about the first day experience, it was good.
Shakti Kishan's first days were amazing, okay? Their food was heaven. It was like eating from hotel. In fact, they really helped me to push my hostel days, because back then eating was the only thing I liked. But now their food is so trashy. You all know, right?
I want to talk about mess food, right? You guys already know about it. Okay, it was okay at the beginning. But as time passed, they really reduced the quality of the food. When we responded, our complaints were categorized into the usual quote-unquote, nobody likes the hostel food. But it was really, really bad. There are instances in which I would just skip a meal so that I don't have to face that food. I really got to know that when I went to IIT Madras for an 8-week internship. Man, food that they served there, it was on a whole different level. So I hope our institute gets better mess in future. That's all I can say about the mess food.
The mess was initially good. It was much better than I had expected it to be. Then as the days went by, the quality dropped. Then it became the mess that I was kind of expecting. And the mess was never comparable to home food.
First mess food was like, we signed the documents, went into the hostel, kept my luggage there. And me, my father, he was the one accompanying me. He came to Palakkad. So we went there, stood in the line. It was really long because everyone was there. We started to eat. The first reaction, like, I did not have any expectations since I've never been in an hostel, but my father has been, and he has actually seen a lot more. So the first reaction was actually from my father. He was like, you're lucky, you got a really good mess. Indeed I was, because I do know that the mess food is can be actually much worse. I got to know that a bit more late, but little did we know that that good food was only supposed to last for a while. But even still, it was quite manageable, at least for me.
Regarding vehicles not being allowed in IITs, I was well aware of this fact even before I joined IIT. So that's kind of disappointing, because you always, you know, dream of having bikes into colleges, you know, roaming around with friends and all. That's what they show in their typical Bollywood movies, you know. But I was like, I knew for the fact that bikes were not allowed, and I was kind of prepared for it. But I think it's a good thing to do. I mean, I might sound technically or politically correct saying that it reduces pollution and all. That's just one part of it, you know. The next is, you have cycles, which is very good for your fitness, and having cycle trips with your friends in the beautiful campus like ours is a really good experience to have. So yeah, initially it feels bad that, okay, you don't have bike, you are in the engineering college and all, but you get adjusted to it pretty well. Yeah.
Vehicles, I do support that law because it makes sense. It really helps people who don't have a good bike. Also, that rule is environment friendly, so I am okay with it.
I already knew that IITs don't allow vehicles inside. For a long time, we had to rely on auto rickshaws alone, go just about anywhere. You know what the institute could have done? The institute could have arranged a parking space in which the students can keep vehicles. Using them in campus would still be bad, but we could use it outside. There are many locations in Palakkad ideal for a bike ride. It would have been possible if we had a safe space to keep our bikes. That would have been nice. But yeah, now it's over, so I hope they'll arrange it in the future.
I had known beforehand that vehicles were not allowed for students in any IIT campus, so it wasn't much of a surprise. Plus, there were cycles on sale on the very first day, so cycle was more than enough to know your way through the campus. You usually needed to travel between the academic block and the hostel, and occasionally to the homes and in the Haliya campus near the hospital.
Yeah, about that, it's like I have been to IITs before as well, so I was actually pretty aware that vehicles were not allowed to students. To be frank, it might sound a bit funny, but even till date, I don't know how to ride a bike, how to ride a car. Like, for example, a bike, I still cannot ride. I'm kind of already used to the speed of the bike. It scares me a bit. I know it's a bit strange, but yeah. So, never was a big fan. I loved cycles. I love cycle. I used to take others. Never thought of buying it because the campus was like just very small one, like literally in the corner of Ahalya. So never felt the need also. And whenever I felt it, I just take some of my friends with or without permission. Yeah.
Definitely, at IIT we have people from all across India, so meeting people from different states was a good experience overall. I didn't have much problem in going, talking to them, getting around with people. It was actually a good experience, and one thing I can say for sure is that my English speaking skills got really improved, because most of the time my roommates were Malayalis, and I don't think I found any problem or difficulty in adjusting with people from across states. It was a good experience, you know, getting to know their experiences, their culture, their traditions, the way they live, and of course, the listening to their mother languages when they talk to their parents. Yeah, it's overall a good experience.
That was really nice, meeting people from almost all parts of India. It was really exciting, okay. Sometimes it's very funny when we speak in English, because our language would be a blend of English and mother tongue. But I never interacted too much with non-Malays, because I was too comfortable with Malayalam. I think I was a little reserved. Yeah, when I look back now, I kind of have a feeling like that.
So many guys from different places, different cultures. It was a very unique experience to have friends who come from places you have never seen, people that speak languages that you don't even know. You know, after 4 years, one thing I understood was every state is the same. There are good guys in every state and there are complete a**s in every state.
I had some classmates in school who were North Indians from different parts of India, because the town that I came from, Tuticorin, it had two major industries to which many people used to get transferred to and from different states. So their students used to study in the school that I studied in. But I had never had any interaction with people from almost all states of India. So that was a nice experience that I could never get if I had been in a state college. And I would never trade this experience for comfort of a state college, if you want to call it so.
So many people might not actually believe it, but I was actually kind of a shut-in till 8. I did not exactly talk to people. It's like in 9th I actually started to talk, but due to some of my past image that I had in my previous school at Mumbai, I was not exactly able to make many friends. But I knew that I knew how to talk to people. I shifted to Lucknow in 10th. The language was the same, no problem. Mumbai people speak Hindi, Lucknow speak Hindi. So thing is, it was not much difficult. Then I also got a Telugu roommate in my first year, which also helped things a bit. Like interstate, yes, I won't say it wasn't difficult, because irrespective of how hard you try, language barrier will always be there. An inside joke in your mother tongue, nothing can beat that. That is a fact that I've learned. So it wasn't exactly a smooth journey, but it was more like the difficulties were more like interlanguage instead of interstate. It's easy to talk to anyone in Hindi irrespective of the place they are from. UP, Rajasthan, Haryana. Not that big of a difference, but yeah, that language barrier was there. There is no denying that.
We had to fill a few forms on the first day, and that's where I first met Apoorva. Later, we both were buying cycles. We met Pranavi. I remember Apoorva and Pranavi suddenly started speaking in Telugu, and I was completely blank. And it would happen in the beginning that they would forget and start talking to me in Telugu, and I had to remind them.
Reached the auditorium where the final stage of registration is going on. During the wait, I sat beside one of my future best friends, Vinay. We had a small chat. After completion of orientation, I met other two friends, Nitin and Randeep, and at the night, we four had a small chat. That's my first day at IIT Palakkad.
I was at Indraprastha Hotel. We were having breakfast. I found two people over there, Ishan Gadgil and Shruti Bhagwate. They were the first. And Shruti seemed like she was a fresher, but Ishan, tall, bearded, and I was very much sure that's a senior. I was pretty much intimidated that these kind of creatures were coming to IIT Palakkad. Then at the railway station, I met Gyan Ranjan. Both of us were interested in music. After all the orientation and everything, I met my roommate, Gopal Karwa. He was from Rajasthan. Many of the people were familiar with the hostel culture. It was my first experience and I was finding everything new, and it was good.
Okay, when we came in, the gym was actually quite minimalistic. So there were two treadmills, out of which one was not working, a barbell with obviously the weights that go along with it, and a few dumbbells. Not much. And the area in the mess, like in the Ahalya mess, which is, you know, behind the curtains, that actually used to be the gym area. There was all the foam mats on the floor. It was not much, but yes, the people who were interested then, which was not many, used to do their workouts there. It was, I think, kind of, I wouldn't say sufficient, but yes, they used to manage. That was kind of the gym that we had when we came in exactly.
When I joined, I never thought I would go hit the gym. One of the things that made life at IIT Palakkad better was the gym, especially at the transit campus. The regulars at the gym were so hardworking that it motivated everyone else. We just kept raising the bar higher and higher each day. Everyone at the gym was dedicated towards becoming stronger, and everyone acted as an example to the others. Even though we had very limited equipment and an overcrowded gym, we shared and supported each other. When Animesh used to bring a Bluetooth speaker and he had an awesome playlist, and it was a place where we forgot everything else and just fully enjoyed the time we spent. So thumbs up to the gym, not to the equipment, but people that used to come to the gym.
Wow, this made me recall my first day at IIT Palakkad. Thank you, friends, for sharing your lovely experience with us. And on that note, thank you for tuning into this episode on Dil Dosti Ki Dastan podcast. Be sure to tune in for the next episode where we shall continue our trip down the memory lane. This is your RJ Neil signing off. Stay safe, stay home, and until next time, peace.